What is going on here? This is not the expected behaviour at all. Sometimes I just need more headroom. Let's talk, she's screaming from the bedroom. Sometimes I just need more headroom. Let's talk, she's screaming from the bedroom. Welcome back to episode 2 of my Sheep Game Devlog. It's been a huge amount of time since the last episode, which I can only apologise for really. It's been a crazy few months or so for me, but I'm just about getting back to some sort of normality. So I expect things should get a little bit more regular from now on. With that said, let's get into it. Last episode, I took a while figuring out what it was I wanted to do, and we finished with the idea of building some kind of sheep herding game. I also said fairly decisively that I needed to keep the scope small and do the minimum work to get something playable. I'll be honest, I immediately failed with this. I wanted some low poly sheep that could frolic around my map, ready for herding. But for some reason, rather than buying a pre-made asset, I chose to model something myself. Despite never having done this before, I fired up Blender and got to work. I followed a great video tutorial for this, again linked in the description, and I actually really enjoyed the process. It was something quite therapeutic, tracing from 2D plans and adjusting various edges and vertices until I'd hit the right shape. It took a bit of time to get right, but by the end, I was fairly pleased with the result. I then spent some more time learning and then applying some rigging so that I could animate some basic walking and running movements. I even got something imported into Unity and walking about, but it was only after all this that I realized it was completely unnecessary. I had no initial gameplay mechanics and certainly no logic that would dictate how a flock of sheep would interact with each other. Progress on these things had no dependencies on how good the sheep looked or how well they moved. So I decided to part this work in favor of getting some basic mechanics in the game with some simple static models that I already had. So how do we simulate a flock of sheep? Well, before I began researching what others had attempted to do before me, I started watching some videos of actual sheep for reference. I eventually stumbled across aerial footage which provided a much clearer view of how they moved. And although not exactly the same, I realised that their behaviour was actually very similar to an existing type of simulation that I'd seen before. Boids. For those unfamiliar, Boids is a program that was developed by Craig Reynolds in 1986 to simulate the flocking behaviour of birds. Reynolds realised that the seemingly complex movements of bird flocks was an emergent behaviour that could be implemented as interactions between individual birdoids, or agents, that adhere to a set of three simple rules. Separation, alignment, and cohesion. Separation prevents Boids from crowding local flockmates. Alignment steers Boids towards the average heading, or direction, of the flock. And coherence steers the Boids towards the central point of the flock. These rules combined produce this beautiful emergent behaviour. Okay, but how does this fit in with sheep? Well, sheep exhibit a flock mentality which actually keeps them safe against predators. When grazing or safe from predators, the flock tends to spread out and slow down, but when in the presence of a predator, I thought that their behaviour tended to look more like that of the Boids. As it turned out, other people agreed with me. After a quick search, I came across a paper which attempted to extend the Reynolds flocking model to simulate sheep flocks under the influence of predators. The authors reasoned that the three original rules still applied, and introduced an additional escape rule to simulate how sheep might flee from a potential predator, such as a sheepdog. Like the original implementation, there was the notion of assigning different weights to the combined rules in order to fine-tune the desired behaviour. But before worrying about the escape rule, I went ahead and implemented the standard Boid flocking with my sheep. Well, not immediately. Yeah, that doesn't look quite right. Okay, after sorting that out, I had something working. But it wasn't great. They were looking vaguely like Boids, but nothing really like sheep. This is where the fine-tuning was important. We had a few different variables we could play with to reach our desired result. We could change flock parameters, like the avoidance radius, which defined the closest that they could get to one another before attempting to dodge each other. Also the neighbour radius, up to what distance could neighbouring sheep affect an individual's cohesion and alignment. We can also choose to weigh individual rules separately. For implementing all of this, I saw an interesting example online that defined a modular, configurable system for managing flock behaviours. I'm never sure how deeply to go into code on these, but here's a couple of snippets, and those interested can pause to read more. We have an abstract flock behaviour that defines a calculate move method for all behaviours to implement. The move method takes in the agent sheep for whom we are calculating the move, the whole sheep flock, and a subset of the flock, called context, which contains the neighbouring sheep within the neighbour radius of the agent sheep. Here's an example of the cohesion behaviour implementing this method. It looks at all the neighbouring sheep, averages their positions, and then returns a cohesion move that tries to head towards that average position. Other rules, like alignment and separation, also have code that implements the calculate move method with their own logic. There's then a composite behaviour that iterates through all of its behaviours and calculates one combined move, taking into account the different weights that we've chosen. And then finally, here's the flock code that iterates over every sheep in the flock and calculates what move it should make based on the result from the composite behaviour. So, I messed around for a while before I landed on a combination of behaviours and accompanying weights that seemed to look natural. With that working, it was time to move on to adding predators. This is what the first version looked like. I created a new escape behaviour and added it to the flock's composite behaviour. The way this rule worked was similar to how the paper had outlined. The sheep are given a flight radius, and whenever a predator is within this distance, the sheep flees towards the opposite direction with some amount of speed. This speed is variable depending on how close they are to the predator. If very close, the sheep makes a quick, scared burst to get out of the way. But the further it gets, the less afraid it is and slows down. This varying speed was implemented with a multiplier calculated from an inverse square function, which looks something like this. It includes a softness factor that decides how quickly the sheep should fall off in relation to distance. I then decided to add a second weight to each rule in the main composite behaviour. This second weight would decide the strength of a particular rule when the sheep is under the presence of a predator. So now we have two weights controlling individual behaviours, with and without a predator. Take cohesion, for example. When grazing, the sheep don't need to pack together tightly, although they might still hang around a loose area together. But when a predator turns up, they become scared and allow themselves to group together much more closely than they would normally. You might also soften the separation rule to allow for this. So playing around with all of these weights, I ended up with this. I still think there's room for improvement. Their movement almost looks magnetic at times, but it does provide a reasonably fun way to herd. I've sped it up here, but you can see how they behave and how you can even begin to separate individual sheep from the flock with the right control. I teased it earlier in the video, but here's the latest version, in which I decided to replace the unimaginative cube with something more visual. And don't worry, I'm aware that farmers don't actually herd sheep with a tractor, but I couldn't find any quad bike models I could drop in quickly, and I didn't fancy modelling, rigging, and animating a sheepdog. Well, not yet, anyway. So I went with this simple tractor, added some smoky particle effects for the engine exhaust, and then some tyre marks to leave behind as it drove. It's still a long way from any final visuals, but these small changes make it a little bit more enjoyable to develop and test in these early stages. So what's next? Well, I'm not really sure. I'm leaning towards a small game that revolves around the current basic herding mechanic. Something like a collection of levels that require moving a flock from point A to point B in the most efficient way, whether by driving vehicles or commanding sheepdogs. I would love to hear suggestions in the comments below with where I should take this, if at all. I've not got my heart set on this game, so be honest about why it might suck. As ever, feel free to like and subscribe to encourage my journey, And above all else, thank you for watching. See you next time.